that means. Evil, that means take a backseat, take it back to fat beats with a maxi single. Look at my rap sheet, what attracts these people? It's my gangster bitch like Apache with a catchy jiggle. I stack chips, you better got a half eat Cheeto. Fill him with the venom and eliminate him. Other words, I'm in him. I don't want to hurt him, but I did him in a fit of rage. I'm murdering again. Nobody will evade him. Finna kill him and dump the bodies in a lake, obliterating everything is generator. Renegade him. He didn't make anybody who wanted with the pin of frame. Don't nobody want it, but they're gonna get it anyway. Cause I'm beginning to feel like I'm mentally ill. I'm a tele killer, be killed. I'm a killer, be the venom. Gorilla, you're bringing the killer within me out of me. You don't wanna be me.
Coming up next, how good is this? A matchup for the UFC welterweight division title. So here he is, the number one welterweight contender, getting set to challenge for the UFC's 170-pound title. Took a long winning streak and many years for him to realize this opportunity. He is not taking it lightly. He has said all here during fight week he's appreciative of this opportunity, but he is confident he is going to maximize it and leave as not just a contender, but a UFC champion. Defending, undisputed UFC welterweight champion in a division full of killers, he has remained the hunted at 170 pounds. Now, unquestionably staring at his toughest challenger to date, can he go back home as the champion? If he can, another chapter to one of the greatest welterweight legacies the Octagon has ever seen. The tape for this welterweight championship fight. 4 years the difference in age between these two fighters, with similar height and some differences in reach. All right, now for the particulars inside the Octagon of Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Eve Loving.
This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out O2 Arena in London, England, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC welterweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 21 wins, 3 losses. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Presenting the challenger, Hazardous. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record of 21 wins, 5 losses. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds.
UFC belt on the line, guys. Protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
They touch him up, and we are underway. So here we go, round one of this highly anticipated tilt between the strong striker and the decorated grappler. Any chance that these guys mix it up, or are you just expecting they're going to stick to what got them to the points?
I'm expecting a pretty straightforward approach from both of these fighters. Yeah. The striker will try to lead with his punches and his kicks, and the grappler will try to time a takedown, time a clinch position so he can start to work towards a lot of those great judo throws that he possesses. Once on the ground, he is in his realm and will start to chase submissions.
And they separate. Man, it's
almost like he's got rangefinder out there. Just too easy as he connects with another good series of punches.
If you're boxing this guy, and only boxing him, you will be in trouble.
So both guys landing at will here. Good action early.
Great punch.
Nice defense there. Huge block.
Oh, that's a nice jab from Colby Covington. You know, it's amazing to think not all that long ago people didn't fancy him a striker. Now, looks like a fighter who can truly do it all.
He stood 24 minutes with Kamaru Usman. No takedown attempts, no wrestling. Stood right.
Overhand, now he's hooked.
That's one of those shots. If you take one of them, if you end the night, that one landed right on the spot.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Back to the feet.
A little single collar tie there. Overhand block there by Covington.
Punch on the top. Nice stick with the right hand.
Oh, look at him land another jab.
There you go. There you go.
All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Well, these are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold him,
know when to fold him. Yep, absolutely.
All right, let's go, let's go.
Posturing up now, and he's out. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like
he's going to start trying to move to a submission here. It looks like he's trying to attack an arm triangle. Watch triangle.
The horn sounds for the end of round one.
Well, what a round it was, especially from a striking standpoint. DC, take us through.
High-level striking. I mean, this is what people come through the doors to see. Two men stand on a quarter, chest to chest, forehead to forehead, and let it all fly.
All right, listen. I need you to be more.
Are you ready? You ready?
Fight. Second round here. There with a punch, so pretty good striking display by him thus far.
He throws everything so straight and so accurate.
Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively, protecting his head, raising the guard, and really frustrating the offensive fighter a little bit.
Lesson one, the box press, hands up, chin down.
Up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by Covington. All right, so pretty good damage here with the ground and pound. Nothing superficial about these strikes. They are intending to harm.
A massive takedown.
To go in round two. All right, working out of side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you got to be careful here. Covington's going for a choke here. And he's out. Just over 2 minutes to go in the round. All right, looks like he's got a couple hooks in here, DC, and defensively, you better be careful. Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now.
Posture, elbows, ground. And he's back up again. So the takedowns have been there, as have the get-ups. Man, as he landed a high volume of strikes here in round two, definitely picking up the pace after round one. So he got the message from the corner, and now he is taking control.
Wow, actually got the takedown.
All right, has the guard closed here. Oh, nice job here staying busy off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. And he's back up. 48 total strikes.
Oh, nice double leg, yes.
Seconds left to go in round two. Seconds winding down in round two. Well, you got to stay busy on the bottom. He's doing it here. Nice punch. Watch, so there's the end of the round. He stayed committed to doing damage upstairs and landed a seminal blow in that round.
It was accumulation of those strikes. He kept hitting him over and over to the head. Eventually, he found the one that really did damage his opponent.
All right, here we go with this third round of this. Oh, that is as good as it gets on the feet. His opponent in a lot of trouble now.
That was Kiki Velasquez's punch of choice. Every time he landed that overhand right, he hurt people bad. And this guy has the opponent hurt very badly.
Back to the feet now. His opponent's chin held up.
His opponent's chin held up, but you do not want to be on the receiving end of those types of strikes.
Oh! Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Oh, useful strike on the ground, that was. So we have crossed the midpoint in this one. South position now, DC. We'll see how he chooses to advance from here. All right, side control now, DC. You know he's in his element on the ground. A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
A lot of tricks.
Oh, now trying to isolate an arm, DC.
He needs to move his hips back to cover. He cannot allow him on that angle. Got to be careful, armbar.
Oh, nice job using his
arm. Oh, man, that was slick.
Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent. Man, this is some serious ground and pound. He's trying to put this dude's head, like, through the canvas.
He's one of the better ground and pound fighters we have in the entire UFC, and you're seeing why.
That's three rounds in the books. We are headed to the championship rounds. All right, so there's the end of the round. And on one side, thrill. On the other, agony after that knockdown.
Yeah, he was able to really damage him with that big punch. You see the hands, the speed, how sharp he is, how technical he is. It allows him to land in spots where his opponent is winging punches Great strike landed. Great punch landed to put his opponent down.
All right, here we go. The tension is palpable. Fourth round is underway. You've got a thing or two to say about these championship rounds.
The fourth round is easily the hardest round of
the fight. There, DC. He is officially rocked.
A big, massive hook that really has put his opponent on skates.
Tries the flying knee to no avail. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh! Oh, big damaging knees here to the body.
Look at how fast. The only person I can do this to is maybe John. John, there's a weight difference. I don't know if you know jiu-jitsu much. You miss a lot of your classes. If I'm going to do this to anybody, it's Andy.
All right, he's sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here. And they separate.
As he gets close, oh, man, look at that. Picture perfect. Got to the leg, got to his position, got another beautiful takedown. Now he's chasing the triangle.
And this could be trouble here. Looks like it's pretty tight. He's trying to work his head out of harm's way.
It might be over. Watch triangle. Watch triangle.
And he's out. Side control now. If you're the bottom fighter, DC, what do?
You got to move. You got to shrimp. You got to get up on a hip to try to move your opponent off of you or pull him down to close the space.
Looking to land the right hand. He misses. Oh! Huge right hand!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Just a gorgeous shot there to end the fight. Really just the way he drew it up. He found the opening and capitalized on it to the utmost extent. Nicely done to finish the fight. Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot that ended his opponent's night.
Let's get it inside of Bruce Buffer. He has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 33 seconds of round number four. Declaring the winner by knockout and new undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world.
And new UFC welterweight champion. Those words sound good. He's going to enjoy watching this one back. There's a new king at 170 pounds.
There is nothing better than hearing "and new." It's almost like the weight has been lifted off of your shoulders. The journey is complete. You are now the UFC champion.
Gotta get a good grip on the city. Gonna make you trip.